He risked his life running through back and forth through enemy gunfire to recover the remains of his fallen comrades and to save the lives of 15 Afghan soldiers back back now, Sergeant Dakota Meyer will become the first living Marine in more than 40 years to be awarded the Medal of Honor for his actions. And we're talking about what happened in September in 2009. Joining us right now, it's our privilege to welcome one brave Marine. He's Corporal Dakota Meyer. Corporal, congratulations. You're working construction now. You're 23 years old. You're out. And the president called you?
Yes, sir. I was actually out on a job site about a month ago, and the president had called me on my lunch break.
And he told you what?
He said that he had looked over my package and that he was excited to tell me that he had signed off on the Medal of Honor.
And you're the first living Marine recipient of the Medal of Honor in 41 years. I know it's painful, but going back, can you bring us back to September so everyone at home could understand what happened that day? You're a sniper. You're in the middle of a firefight, and you hear see three Marines and a Navy corpsman were missing. Take it from there.
We went in to do a key leader engagement to go in and meet with the elders of the village called Ganjgal. And there was a group of about 21 Marines in there and 80 Afghans with us. And I was sitting outside of the village with some trucks with another staff sergeant. And they'd end up getting hit. And a little ways into it, air support wasn't coming in. So we decided we should go in there and try to help them get out. We made five trips in there. And when we got in there to find them, they were, you know, they had already been killed.
So you were able to take the equipment off them and take action. So you went back five times to try to recover the bodies, and of course you tried to recover them. What about your training enabled you to put fear aside and just go into the fight like that?
It's a mixture between training and it's a mixture between just morals. You know, your brother's in there, and you know, you don't leave anyone behind. And there was no time I ever thought that they would all be dead when I got in there. But you know, that's just how it happened.
It's such an honor, and it's a great thrill for me to talk to you. And people around the country are learning your story. But how do you process this type of recognition, knowing that you also have an armband on your wrist to remember those who lost their lives that day?
It's hard, you know. It's hard, but you know, there's nothing that's going to be too hard to keep getting their story out and getting the recognition for the guys that passed that day. You know, it's just taking one day at a time, and it's a great honor to be getting the Medal of Honor. It's not for me. It's for those guys. It's for the Marine Corps. It's for the Marines who are serving, and you know, the Marines that will serve.
When do you actually get the honor? When are you actually honored? When do you go?
They said September 15th.
Wow, so it's coming up. I can just imagine how proud your family is and your friends are, and what a privilege it is to be recognized for something like this. Marine Corporal Dakota Meyer, thanks so much for your service. And thanks so much for what you're doing now. And that's a lucky construction company over in Kentucky that has you as an employee.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
All right. Great story. And we'll, of course, track that when he gets to the White House. Marine Corporal Dakota Meyer.